Hello and welcome to 1000 Verses Bible Quiz Channel. Today we have carefully chosen and organized 15 challenging questions to test how well you know the Bible. Before you start the quiz, make sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss our next episode. Give your comment about the quiz and how you've scored in the comment section below. Are you ready? Let's get started. Question 1. To what object does James compare the tongue? Fire. Sword. Ship's rudder. Mirror. The answer is ship's rudder. James, chapter 3, verse 4. James compares the tongue to a bit in the mouth of a horse and a rudder on a ship, just as a bit controls the direction of a horse and a small rudder steers a large ship, the tongue, though small, can have a great impact on directing one's life and causing significant outcomes. Question 2. Which of David's sons rebelled against him? Solomon. Absalom. Adonijah. Amnon. The answer is Absalom. 2 Samuel chapter 15. Absalom, one of David's sons, rebelled against him. Absalom staged a coup to seize the throne, leading to a conflict known as the Rebellion of Absalom. This rebellion caused significant turmoil within David's kingdom and ultimately led to Absalom's death. Question 3. What does Paul say about women's long hair? It is irrelevant. It is a dishonor. It should be cut. It is a glory to her. The answer is, it is a glory to her. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 15. Paul discusses women's long hair, stating that it is given to them as a covering. He suggests that it is a natural adornment for a woman, contrasting it with the idea that men should not have long hair. Question 4. What did Naomi tell the people in Bethlehem to call her? Mara, Ruth, Esther, Sarah. The answer is Mara. Ruth chapter 1, verse 20. Naomi instructed the people in Bethlehem to call her Mara, which means bitter, because she felt that the Lord had dealt bitterly with her by taking away her husband and sons. This expression of grief and hardship reflects the difficult circumstances Naomi faced in the book of Ruth. Question 5. When Jesus told his disciples to beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and Sadducees, to what was he referring? Their bread. Their hypocrisy. Their teaching. Their rituals. The answer is their teaching. Matthew chapter 16, verse 12. The term leaven symbolizes influence or teaching that spreads subtly but can have a significant impact. In this context, Jesus was advising his disciples to be wary of the false teachings and hypocrisy of the Pharisees and Sadducees. Question 6. How was Daniel protected from the lions in the den? By his faith. By a trap door. By a secret passage. By an angel. The answer is by an angel. Daniel chapter 6 verse 22. Despite being thrown into the den of hungry lions, God sent an angel to shut the mouths of the lions, preventing them from harming Daniel. This miraculous intervention demonstrated God's power and protection over Daniel, who remained unharmed throughout the night. Question 7. Everyone that is proud in heart is what to the Lord? Humbled. An abomination to the Lord. Wicked. Forgiven. The answer is an abomination to the Lord. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 5. The verse highlights the disdain that God has for pride and arrogance, emphasizing the importance of humility and righteousness in His sight. Question 8. What did John the Baptist say when he saw Jesus? Behold the Lamb of God. Blessed are you. Rejoice and be glad. My time has come. The answer is, behold the Lamb of God. John chapter 1, verse 29. When John the Baptist saw Jesus, he declared, behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. This statement reflects John's recognition of Jesus as the promised Messiah and the sacrificial Lamb who would atone for the sins of humanity. Question 9. How did the city that Jonah was sent to react to God's message of destruction? They rioted. They ignored it. They repented. They celebrated. The answer is, they repented. Jonah chapter 3 verses 5 to 10. The city of Nineveh, where Jonah was sent to deliver God's message of destruction, reacted in a remarkable way. They repented of their sins, from the greatest to the least. The king issued a decree for everyone, including animals, to fast and put on sackcloth as a sign of repentance. Question 10. Who asked Jesus to remember him when he came into his kingdom? The centurion, a disciple, a Pharisee, one of the criminals. The answer is one of the criminals. Luke chapter 23, verse 42. One of the criminals crucified alongside Jesus asked him to remember him when he comes into his kingdom, expressing faith and seeking salvation in Jesus' final moments. Question 11. Of what specifically was man not allowed to eat in the Garden of Eden? The tree of the knowledge of good and evil. The tree of life. The serpent. The fruit of the ground. The answer is the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Genesis chapter 2, verse 17. God commands Adam not to eat from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, warning him of the consequences of disobedience. This tree symbolizes the boundary of divine wisdom and authority. Question 12. What was Solomon famous for building? A palace. The temple in Jerusalem. A tower. A wall. The answer is the temple in Jerusalem. 1 Kings chapter 6 verse 1. Solomon is famous for building the temple in Jerusalem, a grand structure dedicated to the worship of God and central to Israelite religious life and identity. Question 13. Jesus asked, "Can the blind lead the deaf?" Blind and deaf. Blind. Sighted. The answer is blind. Matthew chapter 15, verse 14. Jesus asks, "Can the blind lead the blind? Shall they not both fall into the ditch?" Highlighting the folly of following spiritually blind leaders who lack true insight and understanding. Question 14. Who told Peter to watch and pray that he entered not into temptation? Paul. An angel. John the Baptist. Jesus. The answer is Jesus. Matthew chapter 26, verses 40 to 41. Jesus instructs Peter to watch and pray that he entered not into temptation, urging him to remain vigilant and prayerful in the face of spiritual challenges and trials. Question 15. What is Paul's command to husbands in his letter to the Colossians? Love your wives. Submit to your wives. Be obedient to your wives. Dominate your wives. The answer is love your wives. Colossians chapter 3, verse 19. Paul instructs husbands to love their wives and not be harsh with them, emphasizing the importance of selfless love and mutual respect in marital relationships. Congratulations, you did it! You completed our Bible quiz. If you enjoyed this Bible quiz, give it thumbs up. Subscribe for more videos like this. Don't forget to share what you've learned about God's Word with family and friends.